morning, my dear students. How are you all today? I hope all of you are good. Welcome to our social studies online class. And today, we are going to start with a new chapter. Please get your student book ready. We are going to do chapter 7, Living Together. We are going to cover lesson 1, pages 91 and 92. So, our topic for today is All Children Have Rights. Who can tell me the meaning of right? No, this right is different from the right which you are thinking about. I know most of you are thinking about right and left. Go to your right, go to your left. But please remember, that right is different from this right. The spellings are same. R-I-G-H-T. Right. But the meaning is different. So, let me tell you, what do we mean by this right? All children have rights. What are rights? Rights are legal, social, or ethical principles of freedom. Children's rights are the basic rights and freedoms that belong to every person in the world from birth until death. They apply regardless of where you are from, what you believe, or how you choose to live your life. These basic rights are based on shared values like fairness, equality, respect, and independence. These values are defined and protected by law. So please remember, all of us have rights and we have equal rights. These rights are given to us by the law. Children also have their rights. They are free and nobody can take their rights away from them. For instance, what kind of rights do children have? Let us see. The right to be heard. So every child has a right to be heard. If you tell me something, I have to listen. The right to a childhood. It is your right to play, to have fun, to be a child. I cannot tell you, or anyone cannot tell you, to go and start earning. Because if you are a child, you have a right to your childhood. The right to be educated. No one can stop you from going to school. It is your right to study. Either you go to school or you study by yourself. It's up to you, but you have the right to study and learn. The right to be healthy. You have the right to go to a doctor if you are sick. Nobody can stop you from that. You have the right to stay healthy. The right to be treated fairly. So, if you are a girl or you are a boy, we should treat you equally. I cannot say, she is a girl, let her play. You are a boy, you should not play. No. I have to treat you equally. If the girl is playing, the boy can also play. If the girl is going to school, the boy should also go to the school. So, we have to treat the children equally. Let us move on. See, right to education. Right to be safe. Right to play. Right to leisure. Right to be heard. I have rights. See, I have written all these for you so you can go through them and you can understand what do we mean by having rights and what are the different type of rights a child can have. Now, I hope the topic is clear. Let us open our books. You can open page number 91 from your student textbook, Rights of the Child. Let me read. All children in the world have rights that can help them live a better life. The rights of the child give the children all the things they need for a healthy, safe and happy life. So if you have right, you can live a better life. You can stay happy. Look at the pictures below. This girl, she is saying, I have the right to learn. Of course, I have the right to have a nice name. See, every child has a right to have a nice name. I have the right to exercise my body and mind. Let us move to the next page. Look at these pictures. I have the right to drink clean water and eat healthy food. So nobody can make you drink dirty water or give you unhealthy food. Look here. I have the right to live in a safe place. So it is your basic right to live in a safe place, to have shelter, to have a home. I have the right to see a doctor when I feel sick. I have the right to speak out my thoughts and ideas. What do you mean by this? If you are thinking about something, if you have any idea about any topic, you have the right to tell it, to speak it out. So never feel sad. Never think that you, as a child, don't have any rights. You have all the rights, but you should use all your rights in a good way. You should never forget to respect your elders. For example, if you want healthy food, you have to request your mother. She will definitely give you healthy food, but you cannot order her. You cannot argue with her about it. Simply because you have the right to eat healthy food, you cannot misuse this right. Always use your rights in a good way. Be polite, be gentle, and in a very good way, ask for your rights. Now, can you answer this question? What other rights do you think a child has? Just try to think of any other rights which come in your mind and tell them, discuss them, because you have the right to speak out your thoughts and ideas. Excellent. Now, let me answer this question for you. I have written here some points. What other rights do you think a child has? You have the right to be treated fairly no matter what. You have a right to education. You have a right for education, play and cultural activities. You have the right to live and grow up healthy. You have the right to have people do what is best for you. You have the right to privacy. You have the right to be safe no matter where you are. You have the right to help and protection if you need it. You have the right to be cared for and have a home. You have the right to have a say about decisions affecting you. I hope this topic is clear, and now you know what are your rights, and you also know that you should never misuse your rights and always use them in a good way. I want you to list 5 rights that children have. So you can write them in your notebook. You can see from the book, or you can think about them and you can write any 5 rights that you think a child should have. We will meet again in our next lesson. Till then, take good care of yourself.